Well, let's talk about this with a woman who is in some ways seen as the face of the people in public media, perhaps an outsider herself. Amy Goodman, the host and executive producer of Democracy Now! It's an independent and ad-free daily news program that just celebrated its 20th anniversary, which will be marked with a new book called Democracy Now! 20 Years Covering the Movements Changing America. Amy, do you think of yourself as an outsider in the media?
Certainly, because the media is so commercial. It is so driven by corporate interests. And it's so important, though, that people recognize there is a whole independent media world out there. I mean, Democracy Now!, we started on 8, 9 community radio stations 20 years ago, and now we're on 1,400 public radio, television, public access, community college stations.
Do you cover a campaign like Donald Trump's differently because you don't feel any commercial pressures?
First of all, we do not emphasize the polls. I would love the media there to be a month without polls. What is the value of these polls? And I know you were just talking about this, but if I am making a decision about a candidate, I want to weigh their record. Do I care what you think or my neighbor thinks or the person next to me? I want to make an independent decision. This obsession with polls, the amount of money that goes into polls, the amount of times polls get it wrong and yet determine the way people go. Instead, pour that energy, investigation, and money into people's records, whether they're businessmen like Trump or they're politicians like Hillary Clinton or Bernie Sanders. Look at their records. What have they done? Compare their rhetoric to what they have done throughout their life. These people are not blank slates.
The same I would say there is value, though, in knowing what proportion of the electorate believes Donald Trump's message is a valuable one.
Well, you find that out with an election. You find it out with the primary and the caucus. And what you just said, the word proportional, yes, that's what's important. Instead, flashing all day, people just should count the times that every network flashes the polls. Are we telling people what to think? We need to really get into their records and continually talk about, for example, Donald Trump. You cannot avoid what he has said. Now, he is not a politician, but he has a long corporate business record that must be investigated.
Right.
You have the kind, you know, calling women fat dog slobs, disgusting
what
animals.
What Megyn Kelly brought up back in August.
Yeah. Right. This is very important. Calling Mexicans rapists and murderers. And just in the last few days, of course, the chant, build that wall, build that wall. The shudder this must send through not just people outside the country, the idea of fortifying America, but about people inside the country.
But hasn't that received significant, maybe even saturation coverage?
The way Muslim parents must feel when their children hear that Muslims will be barred from America. Let's hear more Muslims in the media. I mean, it's not just about pundits talking about how someone must feel, but it's going to the grassroots and looking at targets. You know, the other day you had a really interesting interview with Bob Schieffer, and he said, you know, Donald Trump sort of voices what you want to tell your boss. I don't think it's what you want to tell your boss, you know, what angry people want to say. I think it's the opposite. I think it's he uses the bully pulpit to bully the most defenseless and powerless people in our society. And I think all religions teach, and even if you're an atheist, that there's something terribly wrong with going after the most powerless. That's easy, and it's wrong.
You're talking about Donald Trump? Let me flip it over to Bernie Sanders.
Yes.
And ask you whether you think it's fair that we use these two candidates, that we talk about them in the same sentences.
No.
That we describe anger that exists from the bases of both of these candidates.
Well, there is clearly, we are at a critical tipping point in the way people feel, the disappearing middle class, the fact that people feel so threatened. Now, you can target different causes. Donald Trump chooses to say it's the people who have the least that are hurting you.
And you're saying
what
Bernie targets
Bernie
the people
Sanders
who have the most.
Is, yes, I mean, just look at the study. 62 in the world, two-thirds of them, like 42, whatever, are American, have more wealth than 3.5 billion people in the world.
Is it striking to you that Sanders has made this a mainstream media issue? It's talked about quite a lot now.
It's very, very important. There's no question that he has deeply impacted Hillary Clinton's campaign and touched a nerve in America, if nothing else, that so many people are revved up in this election cycle. Young people are getting involved, that they can make a difference. This is enormous.